Well, we may be trying to move past Omicron, but that doesn't mean that doctors will stop trying to learn more about it. And there is some interesting new research out there.
Joining us for a closer look is Dr. Alysse Wurcel, an infectious disease specialist at Tufts Medical Center. Thank you so much for being here.
Thanks so much.
You know, we know that two recent studies found during experiments that the Omicron variant survived at least twice as long on surfaces like plastic, paper, skin than the original COVID strain. Does this help explain why it spread so fast?
When I reviewed those studies, they're still in preprint form, so that means that other researchers haven't really reviewed them yet, and just to see if it's quality data. I mean, I think it's an interesting hypothesis and needs further investigation. But at this point, I'm reluctant to put any too much weight into those studies until other researchers review them.
Interesting. So as we said, scientists will be studying all of these variants, of course, long after the rest of us have moved on. So what exactly are they hoping to learn when it comes to preventing another pandemic?
I think there's always been these awkward situations where you're like, oh, I was 6 feet away from someone, but they weren't wearing a mask and they were coughing. And we knew a lot of the early days with the cruise ship outbreaks that we felt we didn't really know how to understand who's exposed and who's not exposed and the best way potentially to eradicate the environment of Omicron or of COVID in general. So I think studies like this help us get a better grasp of, okay, if there's a situation in which someone has COVID and they coughed and there might have been a glass close by, and then, 5 hours later, I put my hand on that, should I seek medical attention? Should I take a medicine to prevent COVID if I'm at high risk? I think that's where those kinds of studies come in.
Kind of reaction to things. I'm going to ask you about the subvariant that we're talking about right now, the BA2. A lot of folks are wondering about COVID cases. We know we're up 48% in the UK last week. All during the pandemic that happens there has been a preview of what's to come in the US. So what are you watching, and is there anything that concerns you about it?
My understanding is that variant has been here already, and there's an interesting dynamic going on between how much of the original Omicron variant and this B2 variant we have, how they're competing with each other, the vaccination rates here, the differential relaxation of mitigation factors that happened in Europe. So I agree, UK has always been a sign of what's to come, but I think there are a lot of things suggesting that that's not going to be true for us. I hope not. At least I hope not. I think we need to be prepared. But again, I am hopeful.
We all hope not. That's for sure. Dr. Wurcel, thank you so much. We appreciate your time as always. Have a great weekend and stay well.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.